All right, so we're out here at Steagerville getting ready to watch the fireworks show, and this place is packed. So guess who's gonna be out here on Monday? I'm having some fun in the ground. So got Zoe with me, got Arden with me. So I just want to thank everybody for coming out here tonight and dropping stuff for me to come pick it up. Later. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
On those Saturdays when kids go out and play, yo, I was up in my room, I let the stereo play. Was it faded, not jaded, just a kid with a pad and a pen and a big imagination. All this to the line, make it, break it, take it, until I'm overrated. Click, click, boom, I'm coming down on the stereo, hit me on the radio. Click, click, boom.
Well, that was a great show, so it's time for these people to leave and for my day off to get here so we can get out here and dig up what these lovely people have dropped. Later, y'all. Happy hunting.
Well, we're back out here after the 4th of July show. We're in the area where they had these water slides, the wet water slides for the kids. This is like a little puddle area. I don't know if you're picking that up or not, but can you see what I see? Dug it out about right here, and it looks like I have a ring. This is the first good thing I found all day. I got a lot of clad, and but this is the first good piece that I have found. So it looks like a little kid's ring or something. They were going up and down the slides, or that's a little big for a kid. Maybe that was one of the adults. Yeah, can't really see, get my phone to focus. So we'll see what that was reading. It was ringing pretty good, pretty high. So that's ringing pretty good. We'll get it home, get it cleaned up, see if we can find any markings on it. So happy hunting, everybody. Hope you're having a good day.
Ooh, it's hot. Okay, check this out. This might not count, but I'm counting it. So I'm sitting here digging me a clad quarter. Woohoo, got a clad quarter. Big, yeah, yeah.
If I can get that focus, it's gonna be hilarious. I got some people watching. It got me some spectators. They wanna know what I'm doing over here. Got me a quarter, and I don't know if this counts or not, but I'm gonna count it. If I can get this quarter put in my bag. Does that count? I think that counts, so I'm gonna count it. I'm certainly gonna count that. That's better than a quarter. Nope, look at here. Got it. Anybody need a baby bottle? I certainly do not. So, got a dollar. Later, guys. Got a dollar quarter spill. Yep. I'll put that in my bag. Happy hunting. It is hot. It is hot. Happy hunting, y'all. Stay safe out there. Hydrate up. Wind to my back. You know what? This is the second time I've been out in a row where I walk up and there's just a ring sitting on the ground. Let's see if I can get that. I haven't picked it up, haven't touched it, haven't done anything with it. Just scanning and sat there and saw it. So let's check it out together. It's a cheap ring. A little cheap ring. Yeah. But a ring is a ring. And I will take it. Sweet. I'll keep finding the cheap rings on the ground. I don't care. Anyways, happy hunting, guys.
Later.
You coming to see if I found silver? He's a talker of the bunch. Alright, just right underneath the stairs here at the tot lot of the park here where they had the deal. And I got me, it looks like a pendant, just underneath the wood chips here. I can already see a cross on it. Oh wow, that is cool. It's a pendant with, looks like the Lord's Prayer. I think this is the second thing I found this year that had the Lord's Prayer on it. The first one was a smushed penny. Man, I'm excited. That's better than the ring. All right, that is awesome. I might crawl underneath there just to get some shade. It's so hot. Oh, well, I hope y'all are having a good time hunting today. It is really hot. But I'll complain until it's fall, and then we'll wish it was summer again. Later, guys. Hope you're having a good day.
We're just going to do a quick wrap-up here. Didn't find a whole lot outside of just a lot of coins, but I did find some really cool stuff. So ended up with 9 nickels. 39 quarters, 47 dimes, and 48 pennies. I also ended up with, that I didn't get on film, was a Canadian penny, 1969. And didn't know I'd got this while I was out there. And apparently ended up with 19, if I can get that to focus, 1945 S. Let me see if I can get that to focus. It's being a pain. Anyways, 1945 S wheat penny. There it is. And I guess I got that somewhere out there because it was in my bag when I got home. Ended up with, oop, I tossed that on the wrong pile. Ended up with a dollar bill, which is floating in the water. I got that on film. I was kind of surprised to look over and see that. Ended up with a few keys. Looks like a little piece to a watch band. And a memory card or something to somebody's cell phone. Sprint, looks like. So somebody's missing it. Probably my best finds for the day would be this little pendant here. It's got the Lord's Prayer on it. It's the second one I found in the last year. The other one was on a smushed penny where they put them through the machines and spit out the Lord's Prayer on it. So that's a really cool
piece. Found that in the tot lot at the park. I initially thought this was a ring. I got that on film, but looking in there, and they has two little spots there with a little rust around them. I'm not so sure if it is. And so at this point, I'm going to say it's not a ring. I just don't know what it is. But like I said, let's see if I can get that to focus. It's got two little round spots in there. I don't know what that's for. Yeah, well, it could be a ring. I don't know. I thought this was going to be another junker as well. Turns out it is faintly marked, but it is marked 925. So I'll take silver all day long. And I will do my best to get a picture of the stamp in there, but it really is kind of worn. So while I'm doing a little video, I want to do a little deal here. This is my Garrett pinpointer. And last week I got home, I thought maybe my dog chewed on it and put a hole in it. Right here, a hole had been worn through. I guess I'm a little aggressive with my pinpointer, rubbing it. And it actually had rubbed a hole into the casing here. Now, I didn't bother to check to see if that's something Garrett would cover. I don't see why I would make them cover it, since I'm the one that did it. And so I was trying to come up with an idea. I cleaned all the dirt out of it. You can still kind of see the little bit of a slant there where I rub it. And ended up getting it fixed. It was like $5 or so at Walmart. The JB Quick. You measure, you put two equal parts of these together, like I did it on a little plastic or paper plate. Mix it together, kind of turns blackish gray, and I just rubbed it all over there, filled the hole in, it covered the hole really well, and you can kind of see what it's done there to it. But it had a really good size hole about right here, and that's on me for just being aggressive while I'm rubbing it. And you can see I even rub it on its side sometimes. But if you ever get a hole in yours, I'm sure if I've done it, I'm not the only one. This is a really fixed it up quick. It really took care of it. It dried in 6 minutes and cured in 4 hours. And I put two coats on it. I've been hunting a couple times with it already, and that's holding up really well. So anybody out there who's like me and ends up rubbing a hole in the housing of your metal detector, you know, once you get it cleaned out, you know, this is what I used to do it, and it was about $4 or $5 at Walmart. And like I said, 6 minutes to dry, 4 hours to cure, and it worked out great. And I still rub it, just I haven't changed anything about it. It's just, and that JB Weld or JB Quick, it's like a JB Weld product. It's holding up really well. So, and I'll continue to use it if I put another hole in it. So anyways, that's the haul for my efforts today from the park after the fireworks show. And I will be back out there again. There's constant activity at that park, so people are always dropping stuff. So happy hunting, stay hydrated. It's really hot down here in Texas. And I hope you find some great finds. If you do, post videos, post your pictures, and have a good one. Stay safe, y'all.